Hey all, it's Fox. I want to talk about Steve Boucher. You may be familiar with this story. It's been floating around the UFO community for decades, but it was only just recently that Steve went public with his experiences, under his own name, in his book, Beyond the Extraterrestrial Firewall, An Experiencer's Point of View. In a previous video, it's there that I retell three UFO encounters some family members of mine have had over the years. I had just become aware of them recently. One of those stories was my father's. It's these stories that eliminated all the doubt I had concerning the phenomena. I am beyond convinced that we are not alone. We are being visited, and it's by an alien intelligence that is shrouded in mystery. While speaking with my father about his experience, he said I should talk to a good friend of his about his abduction experience. As it turns out, my father's friend is none other than Steve Boucher, which makes sense. He does hail from my old stomping grounds. In his book, he references many locations that I am intimately familiar with. It made the experience of reading his book that more engaging. I want to tell some parts of his story. I'll be referencing his book without giving away too many spoilers. It's a great read, with a foreword written by none other than Grant Cameron. But before we get started, I want to thank everyone who has subscribed. I'm having a blast putting these videos together for you, and I know we are a small crowd, but this would not be near as fun without you. Thank you. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. We muse about all things science and technology, with a focus on the stranger things this world has to offer. From quantum woo-woo to the UFO phenomena to everything in between. I truly believe that the truth is stranger than fiction, so I seek out the strange, because odds are, that's where the truth is. But let's dive in. Steve's book goes places that left me pleasantly surprised. We have a very similar understanding of the nature of reality. Steve's understanding of the nature of reality is nicely summed up by the title of his book, Beyond the Extraterrestrial Firewall. He believes that the intelligences that have abducted him over the years are interdimensional and exist beyond a digital firewall, a veil, that they can exist on either side of. Consider this quote from the introduction of his book. The frequencies that construct our reality are comprised of energy and information. They are manifested as fields of geometric patterns vibrating within and around us. Steve appears convinced that our reality is information-based and is indeed a digital virtual construct of one kind or another. I have to concur. He demonstrates some wisdom as it pertains to disclosure as well. Consider this quote from the introduction of his book. Many of us have been clamoring for disclosure regarding what our governments know about UFOs that they have concealed from us for so many years. Perhaps we're looking in the wrong place. Personally, I feel that disclosure will not come to those looking for it in the field of ufology, but from collecting the breadcrumbs being released to us in the various fields of science that have already been disclosed for whoever chooses to look there. I personally believe that disclosure has already occurred, we're just waiting for the details. Many balk at this assertion, but disclosure was never going to look the way we expected it to. As far as I can tell, disclosure is not a grand event in our future, but a collection of facts from our past. A phenomenon this complex can take no other form. When I look at the sum of the information disclosed to date by various entities with different pieces of the puzzle, a relatively clear picture emerges. UFOs are real, they are not from our arsenal. There are many types being observed and have been observed for centuries. They are piloted by an intelligence other than human, and we have materials from these crafts, but we have no idea how they are constructed or applied. And the abduction phenomena is no doubt real, as demonstrated by numerous fellow humans telling their stories, like Steve. So back to Steve. Steve has had some incredible encounters, encounters he's been able to piece together with the assistance of hypnotic regression. In his book, Steve details numerous encounters with the Greys, you know, these ones. This is a picture he drew. He has had numerous encounters from a time when he was a small child to a young adult. His most well-known story is an incident he refers to as the Van Incident. Like many abductees, Steve is an artist, a musician, as well as a visual artist. One night, he was traveling home with his bandmates after playing a private party, when a UFO lands on the highway ahead of their van. Steve describes the craft as such in his book. We were all peering over the seat of the craft. It appeared to be resting on legs, had red lights around the perimeter, recessed portholes, and blue lights emanating from the bottom of the craft that moved back and forth over the surface of the road. It's at this point that the Greys come off the craft and, after some cajoling, escort Steve and his bandmates onto the craft to conduct some tests on them. I would have a hard time believing a UFO would land in plain sight on a highway if the exact same thing hadn't happened to an uncle of mine. I tell his story in the video I referred to earlier. He only witnessed the craft and has no recollection of being abducted, but I don't rule out this possibility, particularly after hearing Steve's story. This was not the first encounter that Steve had had with the Greys. In his book, he details numerous other encounters from when he was a child. One such encounter occurred one night when he was a small child, just 4 years old, while driving home with his father. Again, a saucer-shaped UFO lands on the highway ahead of their vehicle. He witnesses one Grey escort his father onto their craft, while another sits in the car and keeps him occupied by asking him questions, telepathically, about how the car works. The ordeal lasts several minutes, ending with the Greys flying off in their saucer, only to immediately return to drop off a personal item Steve's father had left on the saucer while he was aboard. It's this memory, once corroborated by his father, that inspired Steve to reach out to further investigate his experiences. Yes, his father remembered the incident. He had thought it was a dream, but when Steve brought it up, the memories came flooding back. I think it's important to note that Steve never came out and told his story, with his real name, for over 3 decades. His case had been thoroughly investigated during this time by CUFORN, or the Canadian UFO Research Network, but he'd had never revealed his identity for reasons I think are obvious. He used to go by the handle, Jack T. For the record, I believe Steve. I'm also confident that some aspects of his story are probably inaccurate due to them being uncovered via hypnotic regression. But details aside, there's no doubt in my mind that Steve was abducted, several times. In many cases, only the details of his encounters were uncovered by hypnotic regression, not the actual event. At the end of the day, does it really matter whether there were 5 aliens abducting you, or 4? Another incident that Steve retells in his book was initially unbelievable for me, until I did some more research. It involved the Greys, and none other than Bigfoot. Yes, a Sasquatch, or a creature that Steve could only describe as a Sasquatch. During one of his many encounters, Steve remembers the Greys working with the legendary beast. He describes the encounter as if the Greys had a telepathic hold on the beast and appeared to use it for some of their heavy lifting. Steve remembers a Sasquatch picking him up and carrying him, and a friend, to the Greys' craft. I was unaware of the connection between Sasquatch and the Greys. There is a significant one, and I may explore this relationship further in a future video. As it turns out, Steve's story about stumbling upon the Greys and a Sasquatch while out on a hike with a friend is consistent with accounts retold by many experiencers. In closing, what I discovered while completing some research for this video is that Steve is not alone, not at all. There are scores of people who have shared similar experiences. As far as I can tell, the abduction phenomena is real and worthy of further exploration. Thousands have come forward with their stories, and a few, like Steve, have the courage to tell it all. I suspect this phenomena is much more common than anyone would like to admit. It's a little unnerving, but I think we as a species are much more exposed and vulnerable than we would like to think. I encourage everyone to tell their stories. I think we may live in a time when people are finally willing to listen. I know I dismissed the phenomena as fiction for years, but now I know I was dead wrong and I'm ready to listen. Whatever disclosure looks like to you, lifting the veil on the abduction phenomena and peering through the extraterrestrial firewall will no doubt be an integral part of it. This is possible thanks to people like Steve Boucher who are willing to tell their stories. If you are interested in learning more about Steve's story, check out his website at experiencer.ca. Steve shares his story as well as his art and music on his site, and there are numerous videos available there that go more in depth about his experiences. Take a look, it's quite the foxhole. Thank you for listening. If you like my work, please hit that like button and consider subscribing. And remember, this ride is not without risk. Be careful out there, and take care.